Hi, welcome to Naresh Technologies. My name is Avinash Reddy. In today's session, I will take you through how to create Amazon Web Services account and what are the support plans available with the Amazon Web Services, and we are going to perform console overview. To create an Amazon Web Services account, you need a device with the internet connectivity and a valid web browser. So here, I am going to browse a URL that is aws.amazon.com/free. In this page, you can find all the Amazon Web Services free tier limitations. As we know, Amazon is giving 12 months free tier eligibility. So you can explore all the Amazon Web Services without getting charged. So I am on the page, and here you can find create a free account. If you already have an account with Amazon Web Services, you can select sign into the console. It will take you to the login page. But here I am going to create a new Amazon Web Services account. So I selected create a free account option. So here is a page, and here I am selecting create a new AWS account button. Now it will ask you to enter AWS account name. So this is what account name you want to give. If you are an individual user, you can give your own name, or if you are creating this account for your organization, you can give your organization name. So here I am giving Naresh Technologies and email address. So you can give your email ID, you can use your regular Gmail ID and all. So you have to create a password, and Amazon will recommend you to create a complex password. That means the password length must be 8 characters, and you have to use at least one special character in that password. So I am creating one password. So you have to re-enter that password. So I am clicking on continue. So in next page, it will ask you to select the account type. So here we have two types of the account. One is company account and second one is personal account. So you can use 12 months free tier eligibility for both the types. So but if you are creating this account to explore all the Amazon Web Services options, so I will suggest you to select this personal account. And here, so this is a full name, and you have to select your country. So I am selecting India. And it will ask you to enter the address. So I am entering the address of our institute, and the city, it's Hyderabad, and state, and given the pin code. Here you have to give a valid phone number, and here you have to give a tick mark here. And if you are giving tick mark, means you are accepting all the terms and conditions of the Amazon Web Services. Then I am clicking create account and continue button. So here it will take you to payment page, and Amazon will accept Visa card, MasterCard, or Amex, American Express. So you can use only those three types of the cards. So no other payment option is available. So you cannot use net banking and all. So here Amazon is going to validate your payment option. To validate that one, Amazon will deduct minimum of 2 rupees from your card, and if the deduction is successful, that means you are validating your payment method. However, Amazon is going to refund the 2 rupees back into your account. So you are not going to lose your 2 rupees also. And here we need to have the information of cardholder name, credit or debit card number, and when that card is going to expire. And here you can use your contact address, or else you can use, you can give a new address which is related to this payment option, and it will ask you to enter the PAN information. So if you have a PAN card, you can give yes, and you can give your PAN card number, or else you can set it to no. So here I am going to enter my cardholder name. So for this payment option, if OTP is enabled, you need to have the device in your handy. So you have to complete this payment process, then only it will take you to next step. The payment process is completed now. So here in next screen, it will ask you to provide a telephone number. To validate your AWS account, you have to give your telephone number. Simultaneously, you are going to get a 4-digit PIN number on top of your screen, and you are going to get one call from Amazon Web Services. Whatever the PIN number generated on top of your screen, you have to enter that 4-digit PIN number in that call, then only your account verification is going to complete. I am going to enter the captcha, and I have given my phone number, and that phone number is available with me now. I am going to select call me now. So observe here, when I clicked on this call me now, I got a 4-digit PIN number, that is 0988, and simultaneously I have to get a call from Amazon Web Services, and here is a call. I am going to answer that call.
This is an automated call from Amazon Web Services. Using the touchpad on your phone, please enter the 4-digit PIN number that was displayed on your screen.
So it's asking me to enter the 4-digit PIN number displayed on my screen. So I'm going to enter that 4-digit PIN number. So when I enter that 4-digit PIN number on this call, automatically I got a little tick mark here, and the identity verification is completed. Now I can select my support plan by clicking this one. So here, based on the support plan, you can get assistance from Amazon Web Services. For example, if you don't want to get any charge and you really don't require Amazon's technical support, you can select this basic. You are not going to get charged, and Amazon will answer your queries if it is related to account activation or billing. But you are not going to get any technical assistance from Amazon Web Services if you select basic as your support type. And we have another two types of support types. One is developer. Here, if you are experimenting with AWS, so this is the best type to select. Here, all your technical queries, technical questions is going to answer within 12 to 24 local business hours. Based on the location and that local business hours, your issue is going to addressed by Amazon Web Services representative. But here you can see the price range is going to start from $29 per month. And third one is a business support. So for production environment, I will suggest you to select this business account, business support plan. You are going to get support 24/7 over the phone and the chat. And whatever the ticket, whatever the case you have raised to Amazon Web Services, it's going to address within an hour. So if you have mission critical applications, or if you required support on your production environment from Amazon Web Services, I'll recommend you to select this business account type. But here you may observe you are going to get charged $100 per month. So if you don't want to get charged anything, if you want to use all the free tier limitations, then you can select basic. Then I am going to click on this continue, and the account process is completed. I am going to click on launch management console. Here you can see registration is confirmed. Now I can sign into the console. So here I have to give my email address, and this user is going to call as root user. Whatever the email ID you have given to create this Amazon Web Services account, he is going to call as root user. He will have the highest privileges on your AWS account. So I am going to give my email ID which I used to create this AWS account. It's asking me to enter the password. So I just entered my password and clicked on sign in. So I logged into my AWS portal successfully. And in previous session, we have discussed about the regions. So Amazon have 16 regions, and region, that's a geographical location. Each region will contains of minimum of 2 availability zones. Availability zone is nothing but a physical data center. So now I am in Ohio region, and I can switch to any of the region based on my choice. So here I am in Hyderabad. Mumbai is the nearest region to me. I am going to select this Mumbai region, that is Asia Pacific. And here you can select, here you can find, you can manage your account, you can manage your all the billing options, you can sign out from your account. And if you want to raise a ticket with Amazon Web Services, you can go to support option. Here you can find the support center. So for example, if you want to change your support plan later on, you can come to this page, and here you can see view support plans option. If you want to change this one, you can select this view support plans. You can select a support plan. Here you can find all the available support plans. So these are the support plans available. First one is basic, that is our current plan. And second one is developer, third one is business, and we have enterprise support plan, but the price is very high. It's starting from $15,000 per month. So I believe basic is sufficient for us at this moment to explore Amazon Web Services. So here I have logged in as root user. He will have highest privileges on my AWS account. For example, if I want to change my payment plan, or if I want to close my AWS account, so he is a user, have that permissions. So you have to log in with the root user. We have another user types, that is IAM, that we will cover in further sessions. So here I am selecting my account, and you can find all the billing information and your account information in this page. So every AWS account is going to allocate with 12 digit account ID. That account ID is unique for each and every account. So if you want to close your AWS account later on, you can scroll down, you can come to this page and you can scroll down. Here you can select close account, then you can click on this close account option. This AWS account is going to close. And sometimes you may get issues with the payment options and all. So if you want to change your payment methods later on, you can come to this page, select this payment methods. You can add a new card, and while adding that new card, you can make that as a default one. If you add one more default card, you can remove the existing card. So by this way, you can change payment method, and here you can go to bills, you can select month, and you can track all the usage. And this is a brand new account we have just created couple of minutes back, so I am not going to get any summary for my bills here. So in today's session, we have seen AWS account creation process and selecting the support plans, and we have quick overview about Amazon Web Services portal page. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to Naresh IT YouTube channel. Thank you.